Welcome today. I'm going to show you how to use standing ink to make clothing, or to decorate t-shirts, really. We're not going to make clothing, but we're going to decorate them. And I'm here down here, we have some samples of the bag, and some t-shirts, and pans. You can basically put it on anything that you can iron to heat set. You can decorate with these inks. So the first thing I'm going to do is t-shirt. So I've already taken the t-shirt and taped it down onto a board on the inside so I can isolate my image to just the front, and then that way it won't bleed onto the back of the shirt. So just some masking tape and some nice cardboard or mat board will work really well for that. So I'm going to take my stencil image. This is a really cool helmet design from Stencil 1. I'm going to lay it on there. And I want to make sure that I don't get any overspray. I don't want any overspray on this particular design. So to keep that from happening, I'm just going to take some scratch paper here or some binder paper. And I'm just going to tape it to the edges of the stencil. And then that'll make sure that I don't get any extra spray on the shirt where I don't want it. So I'll just do that to all four sides here. Real easy. And make sure when you do this, I've done this many times before, you don't accidentally tape over the stencil image itself. So you do want to make sure I'm pretty close right there, but I think we'll be all right. So I'll just cover up these other two sides. I like to use binder paper for this because we get some really neat oversprayed designs that will happen on the binder paper kind of organically, which are fun to go back and incorporate into cards or scrapbook pages or journals or whatever you're working on. Okay, I'm just going to get this one last corner here. Make sure that's all covered up. Okay, so we've done all our real technical taping there. Now I'm going to pick my spray color. You can hear that noise in the background. I have a new kitten, and she's dragging her toys everywhere. So, okay, so I'm going to use the memory mist, and I think I actually want to do that in blue Hawaiian right here. I'm just going to do around the outside. And you don't have to use a whole lot, because it doesn't really look dark right now, but when I take the stencil off, you'll see how much ink is actually soaking into that shirt. So do a little pale ale right here. And I think we'll finish it off with a little bit of orange juice right here. Just do a little bit along the edge here. Alright. So now I can go ahead and pull that off. And kind of set this monster here to the side. And here's what we get. So now you're going to take this, and to make it permanent, all you need to do is you want to take the backer board out of here first and slip it onto your ironing board. Put a little cloth on top of it here, like a little blotter cloth or some freezer paper or something. This will go over the top of it. And then you're going to iron it on a low setting, no steam, for maybe 30 to 45 seconds. You kind of want to hold it and just wiggle, hold it and wiggle, and then you'll peel this off, and you'll be all dry and ready to go. I'm not going to show you the ironing, but that's how it goes. And then you'll end up with these here. So like we have on this tote bag and t-shirts and a pair of khaki pants, a couple more t-shirts. So how about we do one now where I want to have some overspray, and I can go back and incorporate a little bit of stamping ink into that. So here I have a men's shirt, and I didn't tape this one all of the way down because I want the design to be all over the back. So I'm just going to set this down like so. Maybe we'll just tuck the arms in a little bit. Like here. So I'm just going to kind of go crazy here with the spray for a second. Let's do it in a kind of rainbowish pattern. Red. Now when you're using this much spray, what I like to do is go ahead and just let it hang dry for, I don't know, maybe 2-3 hours and then iron it. But That way you don't have to handle it so much while this ink is still wet. So, let's do a little bit more blue. Getting kind of tie-dye here for fun. Okay, now I want to go back with this little stencil. I'm going to put this right here in the center, or off-center. And with my palette black ink pad and a little stencil brush, and I don't have to tape this off now because I'm not going to go around the edges, I can go in and fill in this detail. This palette ink is really nice. This one will be dry almost immediately, but it heat sets really fast, a lot faster than the mists do. So now I have this cool little spray bottle here, and add a little shadow underneath, make it look real, a little bit right here, and then maybe like this, make it look like it's spraying. Alright, so that's pretty much our shirt right there. Nothing like that. And again, you're going to want to, I would say let this hang dry for maybe half an hour, maybe an hour, and then go ahead and heat set it. You can also, the other thing you can do is let it hang dry for maybe an hour, and then throw it into the dryer. But I would turn it inside out and make sure there aren't any other materials with it. And then, you know, you could always, for a shirt like this, would be fun to maybe turn it over and do another little isolated spray can maybe on the front right here in the center with the back. Finish this guy off. So I'm going to take that same stencil, maybe instead of doing the black, let's do some overspray. And then you can see how it looks when we get the frame of the stencil in the design. So let's do a little bit of blue again. And do a little bit of, well, orange juice is one of my colors of the moment, so let's do that. So we got this guy. This will all wash off with water. So that looks pretty good. I like that. All right. So that's how you use the mists and palettes on t-shirts and fabric. I'm going to have these samples up on my blog, so if you have any questions, make sure you visit the blog. And we'll be back next time with another super cool project. Thanks for watching.